Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. This is Isabelle from Liabelle Nursery. Welcome if it's the first time. I doubt it because we are in the last part of our tutorial. If you haven't seen the previous part, I suggest you go ahead and go watch the first part of this tutorial. We are almost done with our reborn, our painting. We have just some detail left to do in the nails, some capillaries, maybe go over some of the darker crease. At this stage it's almost complete. You can always add a little bit more layer of primary wash if you feel it's pale, it's too pale for your taste. I think this one looks good for me. I will stop there with the washes, but if you wish you can go ahead and give a few more wash. At this stage for the last washes, what you can do is go with the light purple wash or a sap green wash. It gives a very, very nice result. So that's something you can do if you find it's a bit too pale for your taste. I don't have a lot more to add for the crease in this one because I have done the crease almost last. So they are still dark enough, but I will show you what I do anyway. For this, what I like to use is the Reborn FX Eyelid Purple. It's a very deep dark purple, but you can make your own with a blue and red, naturally. So I will put blue here. My red there. You can use any kind of blue and red, no matter the type. You can also use dioxazin purple. Nice name. You can use it and add a bit more red to it if you wish, or a tad of brown to make it a bit darker. So I will not need all this paint, so I will just go and mix it there. Seem dark enough to me. I will not use any medium except my retarder. That should give me enough working time. So if you use this one to compare, that's almost the same. Almost the same color. This one is the one I have made. This one is the eyelid purple, so we are okay with that. Usually what I do with this color is I do the inside of the ear. If you find that it dried too fast, you can add a little bit of water in it. And you go over all the crease that usually on the skin they are very dark almost black. I think even with the retarder it's a bit too strong. Just a drop. I don't want to dilute it too much. I will go inside the nostril. You may have to do a few layers inside the nostril, depending on how dark you want them to be. If you have a deep crease around the nose, that's a good idea to put a little bit around the nose. Don't spread it too large, just put it in the crease. I will go over the eyelid with this color. All over the eyelid. It will give a really nice translucent tint. I'm more used to use the Reborn FX. I don't need to dilute it like the golden paint. If you have deep crease around the neck, you can go around the neck, can go behind the ears, everywhere you think you may need to add a little bit more deep. Now for the end, I go when the fingers are together, I go in the middle. Go between the finger that are stuck together. Try not to spread it too far. And I go inside the end and do, usually I do the same. I do not need to put a lot. This kit I already have a dark crease, so it's not an obligation, but it will help if your crease, if you have done many layers after you have made your crease, that's good to go over them a last time. Don't be afraid to get darker crease. Not everywhere. Some crease are very faint, like those in on top of the arm. But if you have really, really deep crease, that's a good idea to go over with a darker color. If you look at your own end, you can see that some crease are really, really, really dark, almost black. But the black doesn't give a good result with the reburning. So we go with something dark enough, but more natural looking. I do the same with the feet. go between the toes. And it really depends on your kit. Not all kits have the same trees everywhere, so you will be a judge on where you think it's a good idea to put some. And for the torso, put it all over the deeper crease. And on the belly button, I like to put this purple all over the belly button, but it's really a matter of preference. I think it looks a bit more newborn. But if you have a kit that it's supposed to be a bit older, you may not want to do the belly button very dark. I have forgot one place on the head. I have forgot the inside of the mouth. This one is difficult to open because the kit is very hard. But if you can, if your kit is soft, press open the cheek so you will be able to reach inside the mouth. You may want to go and put more layer. Two, three, four layer until it's dark, almost black inside of the mouth. That's it for the purple for now. Don't throw it away, we will need it a bit later. Now for the capillaries, I will add a little bit of brown here. I will mix red with a touch of brown to get a bloody red. Again, drop of two of retarder to be able to work with it. And with that, you will do your capillaries. It's not an obligation. If you don't feel comfortable doing it, don't do it. There's nothing wrong with that again. Usually we will do some capillaries on the eyelid. This one is as his eye open, so it's a bit difficult for me to show you exactly where to put them. But you can look at picture of real baby, and try to see where you can add capillaries that will look natural. For doing capillaries, just take a very thin paintbrush and do very, very thin line. And then pounce it with your finger or a sponge. Don't do straight line. Try to keep them squiggly, like the vein. Not sure if you see well enough. Don't do too much. You can put them inside the ear if you want. It's really up to you. If you have seen a picture, a close-up picture of baby, you can try to replicate. It's really just that, a few little line here and there. You can use the same color if you want to do something like some of a rash. The front, and then you pounce it very well with a sponge. I think you call it a stark bite in English. Don't think we have really a name for that here. Kind of a marking that very, very small newborn can have. Can also replicate some skin irritation. Be careful, don't do too much. Don't want to have a blotchy baby. Just something that look a bit more natural. You can do this with your sponge if you feel it. Just put the paint on your sponge, press it on the paper, and go over the cheek or the temple. Wherever you want it to be. And if you want a little scratch, use the same color. You can do a little scratch. Don't overdo them. One or two little scratch is okay, but too much. People tend to not like this very much. Just a little bit. You can go in the middle with a bit of brown. Just a little scratch, nothing too dark, nothing too big. She looks very blotchy. I have already have a good blushing on her. So at this stage, you can go over your blushing if you think it needs a little bit more. You can use your color of blushing you have already used, or you can continue with the bloody red if you think needs more. Usually the toes and fingers tend to use a little bit more blushing than the rest. But mine, I think it looked okay with that. Now the last part, the nails. I'll try my best to show you because it's not easy to get on camera. It's so tiny. Need a good light, and my zoom sometimes have trouble with it. So I will try to show you. I will not show you all the nails. I will show you one or two, and you will be able to do all the rest of them. First, beginning with your purple. I like to do the end of the nail near the finger. I like to do a little bit of purple there, and I spread it toward the middle. Those nails are really not very realistic. So I don't go up to the tip. I try to stay in the back of the nail. Then after that, you can use your crease color or your bloody red that you used for your capillaries. And I like to go over in a moon shape like that. That and just spread it again towards the tip. And those will not be perfect nail because I struggled to keep it in front of the camera and doing them at the same time. I don't see a lot of what I am doing. Nails are so small. It gives an appearance of a little moon, but not too white like some people do, because on newborns it's not usually a thing to see very very bright white moon. Now for the tip of the nail, you have two choices. You can use a flesh tone if you have one on end. You can use a baby flesh tone, or you can use Titan Puff. Nothing bad with that. Try not to use a plain white. It's possible to use white, but if you use white, go with a little touch of blue, maybe. Just not have a bright white. Nails are not white. Unless you just have a manicure, They are not usually very, very white. Go ahead and mix a lot of medium, as much as you can with that. You want to have a really a lot more medium than color. It will give you this translucent look. I have red on my brush. Just a little bit of paint on your paintbrush. Then carefully go on the tip and just trace a very, very thin line. If your nails, the nails of the doll, are sculpted to be long, you can go with a little bit wider line. But in some doll, like this one, nails are short, so you're not supposed to see a lot of the white nails. Just a little bit. I'm very sorry for the zoom. It's very hard to keep painting and keep the zoom. Like this very small line. And I suggest that you use a retarder, a lot of medium, and a retarder with your red, because you will have the chance to erase it before it dry completely. It will give you a chance to redo them if you're not happy. Now the final step, those are really not my best nails. I have made them a few times on other tutorials, so you can go ahead and look my previous tutorial. Now what you will do is a line, a little red line just under the white one, and just spread it a little bit, just to not have it too harsh. Don't put too much paint on your brush. Just go very, very light. This thumb is nicer than the other. And after that, the same color, you can go, or with the purple, you can go under the nail, in the little crease under the nail. That will make them appear more 3D. then that's it for the nails. Like I said, they are not the best in the world, but for now I think you have you understand the processes. If you absolutely wish to make a moon, you can go with your nails tip color and go put a little bit of a moon shape. I think the term is lunula. I'm not sure. Just like that. Nothing more. So now for with the white, if you want, you can add a little bit of a milk pump. I don't suggest you to do it if you are a beginner. It's very, very hard to do them to look realist enough. But if you really, really want to add some, go with a really fine brush or a needle or a toothpick. With your white very diluted medium, you can go and just put some little dot. You don't want to put too much. Usually it's on the nose. Put them different size. But they must be very, 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 very small. Almost invisible. Don't put something something like that unless you want it to be acne. This is really too big. It will not look good. It will not look natural. It's a process in itself to do it right. I really don't do them often. I don't like very much the result. I'm not good enough to do them and get a nice result. But if you really want, you can just do just some little spot. If you want to do acne, you can. Usually you will have a white dot like that and a little bit of pinkish color around. Like that. And later with the varnish you can go over and put a drop of varnish on top to make it bumpy a little bit. I think we are done, I think. Don't forget anything. I didn't paint this week, really. I have made a tutorial, not a tutorial really, a comparison between different varnish and medium. I will put the part 2 online this weekend for the medium part. I suggest you go watch it. I know it's in French for now. I try to find a way to do the translation without having to do it all by myself. I don't know how to. If someone know how to do the subtitle in English. But I think you may get the idea, because I really show all the varnish and the number, and I show you the result at the end. So even if you don't understand what I say really, you will be able to see the result at the end and see which one is the more matte. Same with the medium. So it may be a good idea to watch it, because the next and last part of the tutorial will be varnishing the kit. So maybe a good watch for you before this step. So that's it for today. The next part and the last part will be the varnish. It will be shorter because I will show you how to seal and varnish, but there's nothing very complicated about it, so it will be a bit faster. And until then, I suggest you to not start to varnish yet. If you have just finished with me your kit, you have to wait it to cure a good week, at least. Maybe 2 weeks is best, but at least a few days. No less than 3-4 days is the bare minimum. You will have to let the paint very set on the kit. So until then, it's not a good idea to varnish already. So put your kit aside, let it cure very well, and next time we'll varnish this little baby. I wish you a good week and see you later. Goodbye.